Springfield's classic country, 105.1 The Bull. And you know all the words to his songs. Watermelon Crawl, Keeper of the Stars, 10 Rounds with Jose Cuervo. The list goes on and on, and I am truly honored to talk with him today. Tracy, let me just start out by saying we are so excited to have you in town Friday night.
Well, great, man. Yeah, we're looking forward to it, too. We hadn't been to Springfield since we were there with Cody Johnson a while, about 2 years ago, I think. So we're looking forward to coming back.
That concert Friday night at Southbound. Tickets are limited and available right now at our website, thebull1051.com. Now, Tracy, the world, well, it's basically at a standstill with COVID-19. What have you been up to since all this went down?
Well, you know, over the summer we were, you know, totally shut down like so many folks were, and we just made the best of it and got caught up on some things that had been needing to catch up on, I guess, and spent some time with family and played a little golf and just kind of got through it like everybody else was doing. But we've actually worked, about 15 shows, I guess, since late July. And a lot of social distance shows and some drive-in shows and things like that. So, you know, we've still gotten out there and played a little bit. And I know the folks, I don't know who loves it more, me being able to go out and play or the folks being able to come out and hear some live music. But we're really glad to do it, man. We're really glad to be back to work. And hopefully we can get all this stuff on behind us and get back to living life as normal like we've all been accustomed to. I tell you, to make you wish you had your old life back, for sure.
Yes, sir. I think we're all ready to get back to normal life. Quick question. Be truthful. How is your golf game?
I'm a 4 handicap, so it's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's up and it's down. You know, that's the nature of the game. But usually if I'm driving the ball well, I play pretty well.
Okay, that's pretty impressive. Now, I read on the internet, which, you know, Tracy, if it's on the internet, it's got to be true, that you were in a band with Mark Chestnut early on in your career. Is that true?
Well, not exactly. Well, yeah, I guess it is true. He had gotten his record deal, and I was playing across town with another band, and the owner of the club that Mark was playing at wanted me to start playing there when Mark left to go on the road, so I did come over early and leave the band I was with and came over and played with Mark and his band to kind of, you know, break me into the gig and get the crowd used to me. So I guess in a way, yeah, we did play in a band together, but it was really his band and I was just kind of setting in. But then after he left, I put my band back together and took over, and then we both, you know, I ended up signing with MCA Records just like he did. So, you know, Mark and I have been kind of joined in different ways for a long time in the music business and in friendship. So we're both, you know, we're Beaumont boys. So yeah, I guess we were in a roundabout way, we were in a band together.
Now, Tracy, you've had a bunch of hits throughout your career. When did you really know that you had made it?
I mean, the first number one record was obviously a milestone, but I guess I really... When the second album came out and Keeper of the Stars hit, we hit 1 million records sold for that album. I think that's when I really said, okay, maybe I got a little bit of staying power and maybe I can, actually stick around for a few years. And thankfully, we've stuck around for many years. And man, still just having a great time with it. And I guess are playing as many shows these days as we ever have.
Well, there's no dispute you have a huge fan base across the country, and I know you're loved in Texas, but you're just as loved right here in Springfield and our surrounding areas.
Well, I appreciate it. I'm just glad to still be able to come out there and play for folks and still have them singing along to these old songs of mine. So we're looking forward to Friday night for sure.
Are there any songs throughout your career, maybe one or two you passed on that you just wish you hadn't?
Well, there's a couple of stories. I actually cut a song on my first album that I'd been playing in the bars, you know, down in Beaumont when I was trying to get a record deal. It was a song a guy I knew had written. It's called Alibis. And I actually cut it on my first record and didn't really like the way that we cut it and the way it came out and was planning on cutting it on my second record again, recutting it. And in between me and that first record and that second record, Tracy Lawrence heard it and he cut it and had a number one hit on it. So so that's one that kind of got away. But other than that one, there's really not... not any other ones that I think I really missed on, you know, that but that one stung a little bit, still does.
We're going to have to give Tracy Lawrence a hard time. He actually hosts a show for us every Saturday night right here on The Bull.
Oh, good. Yeah, that's right. He's in on to doing his show. Yeah, we shortly after that, became really good friends, and to this day are still just great friends. And I joke that I've been in all of his weddings, so. Yes, that's how that goes with us.
Now, you used to host TNN Outdoors. Do you get much hunting done throughout the year?
I don't do as much as I used to. I still go once a year. I love to bow hunt, and so I'll go during the rut usually, and that's usually these days my couple of weeks that I do it, and that's about it. Maybe hit a duck hunt a couple times a year, but not near like I used to. As the old saying goes, I ain't near as mad at them as I used to be.
Yes, sir. Are there any up-and-coming country artists that maybe you'd like to tour with in the future?
You know, there are a few guys that are starting to traditional guys that are starting to come around. Of course, I mentioned Cody Johnson at the beginning of the interview, and he's an old Texas guy, and he's really done well with a pretty traditional sound. And there's a guy named Mo Pitney that's been out for a few years that I think's really good. I hope he can hit his stride. And I like that traditional country music, and I'm always excited when I hear some guys come out that's got that. Old Luke Combs does a great job of that, and traditional country in a real modern way. So there's a lot of talent out there, I tell you, a whole lot of talent.
You know, a few years ago, I actually talked with Aaron Watson, and your name got brought up, and he had nothing but amazing things to say about you and how you actually inspired him a lot growing up.
Yeah, man, Aaron's a great guy and a good man, and on top of being a great artist and great singer, he's one of those Texas guys down here that, they could make a career alone in Texas, but they're starting to venture out and get all over the country, so I'm happy for them for that, because there's some great talent down here.
So, Tracy, we had a comment on our Facebook page I just had to mention to you. Said you were in town a few years back. This would have been probably maybe 10 years ago. The owner of the venue had to turn the lights off because you and the crowd were going to party and play all night. Is that true?
Well, I heard about that, and probably very true. I used to like to push it for a long, long time. So, yeah, you never know. Friday night, we might stretch it out a little bit. We love to play, and we get out there, and we start going, and I'm rolling down the set list, and then I'll just go off on a tangent and start singing, different songs, and people start yelling out songs they want to hear. And so if you want to hear something that night, folks, just yell it out. We'll play it, and ain't no telling how long it'll last.
Now, the concert Friday night will be full band, right?
Oh, yes, full band, yes, sir. Steel guitar, fiddle, piano, guitar, drums, bass, and me. It's a big band.
Well, Tracy, we are really looking forward to it. Tickets are on sale. They are limited, and they are going quick. So get all the details you'll need to see Tracy Byrd Friday night at Southbound here in Springfield at thebull1051.com. Tracy, a true honor to speak with you, sir, and we really look forward to having a good time and really some normalcy on Friday night.
Well, thank you, Cruz. I appreciate you too, man. We'll see you there.